MedCram.com.
Welcome to another MedCram Board Vitals question. This question comes from our family nurse practitioner banks. And the question is, what are the three bacterial organisms that are the most common causative agents of CAP, or community-acquired pneumonia, in adults? First choice is A, and that's Klebsiella pneumoniae, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and Haemophilus influenza. B is Mycoplasma pneumoniae, Chlamydia pneumoniae, and Streptococcal pneumoniae, which is the correct answer. C is Haemophilus influenza, Chlamydia pneumoniae, and Moraxella catarrhalis. And D is Legionella species, Chlamydia pneumoniae, and Mycoplasma pneumoniae. So which one is the right answer? In this case, it's B. But the question is why is it the right answer? So let's review that. So I wanted to go over these eight different bacteria and their characteristics. So the first thing you should know is that streptococcal pneumonia is actually the most common bacterial cause for pneumonia. So right off the bat, that is the biggest thing you should know. You should know that streptococcal pneumonia is the most common bacterial cause for pneumonia. And if you'll remember, on a Gram stain, they're going to look like Gram-positive cocci in pairs. So that's the thing to look for, is you'll see those in pairs like that. Now, the next one is Haemophilus influenza. Haemophilus influenza is also seen in community-acquired pneumonia, very commonly, but not as commonly as strep pneumo. It's also seen in COPD, so make sure you're aware of that as well. Klebsiella pneumonia, not as commonly seen in pneumonia. It's not a common cause of it, but it is associated with alcohol consumption. These two right here, Chlamydia pneumoniae and Mycoplasma pneumoniae, are bacteria that do cause pneumonia, but they cause a different clinical syndrome. Whereas these ones that we've talked about up here cause a typical type of pneumonia, these are very commonly called an atypical. Now, be aware that atypical pneumonia and typical pneumonia are still under the umbrella of community-acquired pneumonia, which is what the question was dealing with. So there is typical and there's atypical. So be aware of that. And atypical clearly are these two right here. They are also very commonly seen in CAP, even though they are atypical. Atypical means that they're going to have this type of walking pneumonia. It doesn't present typically. Typical pneumonia is fever, white count, infiltrate, feeling short of breath, things of that nature. Now, for the next one, I'm going to use the color green because Pseudomonas is classically green in color. So if you see a patient with green sputum, it doesn't necessarily mean they have Pseudomonas aeruginosa, but you may want to think about it, especially if they've got lung disease, chronic lung disease, like COPD, bronchiectasis, especially cystic fibrosis. This is classic cystic fibrosis. Now, the reason why you should know about Pseudomonas aeruginosa, even though it's not one of those bacteria that's commonly found in CAP, is because of antibiotic resistance. And we'll just touch on that briefly. But first, I want you to remember that Pseudomonas aeruginosa is typically not seen in community-acquired pneumonia because these are seen in more hospital-acquired or healthcare-acquired pneumonia. So it's not one of the most common ones for CAP. So what do we typically treat Pseudomonas aeruginosa with? Well, there's a number of different antibiotics for Pseudomonas aeruginosa, but you can think about the fluoroquinolones. You can think about the carbapenems. You can think about the aminoglycosides. All of those cover them. There are some third and fourth and fifth, actually, generation cephalosporins that cover it, like ceftazidime, cefepime, and zerbaxa, which is a more recent fifth generation cephalosporin. And then you can get into some of the other ones, for instance, aztreonam, which is a monolactam, which can cover Pseudomonas. There's the carbapenems, as we talked about, like meropenem. There are the fluoroquinolones, as we mentioned. Those are the only ones that are available orally. The key, though, here is Pseudomonas aeruginosa is a very specific bacteria that you've got to know a lot about, not typically seen in CAP. Moraxella catarrhalis, kind of known as MCAT, for those of you who have to take the MCAT. MCATarrhalis is typically seen in acute otitis media, can also be seen in COPD as well. And then finally, the last one here is Legionella. Legionella we would not consider part of CAP because it's typically seen in outbreaks. So think of this in outbreaks, if there's an epidemic, okay? That would be on a cruise ship or air conditioning or in a hotel. That's where you want to think about Legionella, not in CAP. So what are ones that we see in CAP? We see streptococcal pneumonia in CAP. We see Haemophilus influenza in CAP. We see these atypicals in CAP. CAP stands for community acquired pneumonia. This is chlamydia pneumoniae and this is mycoplasma pneumoniae. So we're back with the question now, and the question again is, which are the three bacterial organisms that are the most common causative agents of CAP? Well, if you just go with the very first thing that we said, which was that streptococcal pneumoniae is the most common, the only one of these answer choices that has streptococcal pneumonia in it is correct. Chlamydia pneumoniae and mycoplasma pneumonia are the other two, and therefore B is the correct answer. Klebsiella pneumoniae is seen in patients who drink a lot of alcohol, not necessarily CAP. We talked about that Pseudomonas aeruginosa is not seen in CAP, and Haemophilus influenzae is seen in CAP. By the way, influenzae here, this is not the flu virus. This is a bacteria, just so you're aware. C, Haemophilus influenza, yes. Chlamydia pneumonia, yes. M. catarrhalis, no. That is not seen typically in or commonly in community-acquired pneumonia. For D, Legionella species, we've already said that this is not part of the community-acquired pneumonia cadre of bacteria. This is seen in outbreaks. This is seen spread by water, air conditioners, things of that nature. The other two, though, are part of CAP, and that's Klebsiella pneumonia and Mycoplasma pneumonia. Well, thanks for joining us.